नेक्स्ट वन दैट इज नोन एज चेंज द आइटम्स. वी हैव टू चेंज द आइटम्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई वॉन्ट टू एड वन आइटम टू द सेट. द आइटम इज इक्वल टू क्वाज. देन यू कैन ऑब्जर्व हियर दैट इज एडेड हियर एट द लास्ट पोजीशन इट इज एडेड. But it may not be reality also sometimes. Okay. It may not be really last only available. Now, suppose adding the multiple items. We given the fruits is equal to apple, banana, cherry, something like this. Then I want to update here fruits dot update orange, mango, grapes. Now, if you see fruits is equal to what you are seeing, whatever already we have the three plus these three, total six things we got here, right? So, if you want to add only one item, what is the method we are going to use? Add. If you want to add more than one item, what is the method we are going to use? Update. These are the two methods which are helping you to add one item or multiple items to the set. If I want to remove the item, I have here three types of removals. I can go for remove mango. Then it is removed the mango, whatever available. Problem with the remove is, suppose mango is not available in the set, it is going to throw the runtime error, this key is not available like that. Now discard is, suppose we are trying to remove the grapes, it is removed the grapes. Again, if I am executing grapes also, it is not throwing error. If discard behaves, if item available, it removes. If not, it is silent. If not, it is silent, it won't throw any error. But whereas remove is, if item available, it removes. If not, it raises error. Okay. Now pop is, it will remove last item it is going to remove. Suppose we are trying to say as pop, even though it is appearing last item, what is the last item? Orange. That we should not believe it. In the memory, whatever last item available, that it is going to remove it. In this case, apple is available last, that it is removed. Let us go and try to observe these things practically. Okay, we are trying to do manipulating set. So as part of the manipulating, we are trying to learn about add. Add method, this method is useful to add one item. How many items? Only one item only we can go and we can add here. For example, we are writing here A is equal to, again we are creating one set, we are creating that is called as usual I am following the simple ABCs. I am passing A, B, C, I am passing here. Okay, now I want to add here one item, A dot add, then I am trying to give here D, now it is added or not. If you go and try to see A, it is added and we are able to see now A, B, C, D, we are able to see it. Now second is available, that is called as, what is that? Update. It is useful to add more than one item. For example, we are trying to say a dot update. So now we are trying to provide a dot update. Now I am trying to provide here E, then I am providing here F, then I am providing here G. Now you can notice I am able to see A is equal to, already ABCD is available, for that EFG is added. Now next one, I want to understand about what you mean by remove. Remove is going to behave like, if item available, it will remove. Else, it raises error. For example, I am trying to write here A dot, then we are going for removal of, for example, I am trying to remove A. A is the one of the item, right? I am trying to remove it. Now, if you observe here, A, are you seeing here, this is removed or not? A is removed. Now, if I go and try to execute one more time, same thing. A is available or not available now? Not available. As it is not available, it is going to throw error. Anything which is not available, we are trying to ask here to remove, it is going to throw the error. Suppose I am asking remove Z. Z is available here. No, it is throwing the error. That's what the meaning of, if item available, it will remove, else it raises error. Next is available, that is called as discard. What is discard? It is going to do it. If item available, it will remove, else it will be silent. Else it will silent. That means it will not do any work. It will be silent. Now, for example, let us go and try to say A dot, then we are saying as discard. The discard we are saying as B. Now, if you can observe, A is equal to B is removed or not? Whatever B is available, that is removed. Suppose I am trying to write here A dot discard of X, or X I am writing. Is it X is available here? No. It is going to be silent. It is not throwing any error. If your requirement is, if item available, remove it. If not silent, then you can use this. Then, last one, we have here pop. Pop is useful to remove last item of the memory. Not what you are seeing, sir. Not what you are seeing on the screen. In the memory, whatever last item is available, that will be removed. Not what you are seeing it. Here A is equal to, you are seeing last position, what is this? G. On screen you are seeing G, but G may not be available in the memory last position because it is unordered. So if I go and try to say A dot pop, I cannot give the guarantee G only will be removed. If I see here, what is removed? E is removed. Now if I go and try to observe here A, that G is not there. Same functionality, same how it works, same function how it works with list. For example, I am trying to create a list. List is equal to L is equal to, I am saying as 10, 20, 30. Now if I go and try to observe the L, we are able to see 10, 20, 30. And type of L also, we are able to see, what is this? List. If I write here L dot pop, then what you are noticing here, what is removed? 30 only. List is a ordered one. Whatever you are seeing, whatever way memory is available, both are same. That's the reason the moment I say pop, the last what you are seeing, that only removed. But in case of set, that is not happened. These are the points what you need to know about the manipulating the set. Hardly we learned about what is the method? Add, update, remove, then discard, pop. These are the things what you learned. Please practice it.